हाय सलाम नमस्कार मी नेहा आज आली आहे इथे रुस्तम समोर सो गाइज टुडे आय एम हियर टू इंट्रोड्यूस यू द न्यू आउटलेट इराणी आउटलेट पारशी आउटलेट इन बालेवाडी बानेर वेर वी कैन सी वी हैव वेज नॉन वेज एवरीथिंग इन पारसी सो लेट्स कम एंड जॉइन मी इनसाइड
Rustom Battliwala. So, chaliye dosto, let's go and taste this food. And before that, as I said, I request some people to come in and tell us what is it that we have on the menu today that we'll be tasting. So, Neha,
yes.
Papa, so hi, Dipu,
hi.
How are you?
Thank
Welcome
you so much.
Welcome to Chow Down, my name.
Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Yeah, so thank here you. Is Chef Dipu, and he's here. Who's opened this amazing restaurant, the Rustom Battliwala, and with this layout, he will tell us what things are there in for us to taste and tell you how it is. So let's start.
Yeah. So basically, this is an Indo-Parsi Iranian all-day diner. So we start off with breakfast, and we've got lot of Parsi food, lot of Iranian food, and lot of North Indian food also. You know, to match the local palate because. We've got this amazing, the typical Mutton Dhansak, which is a typical Parsi dish.
Yeah.
We've got, of course, the Bun Maska. We've got this amazing veg keema pav for vegetarians because, you know, vegetarians sometimes say, like, you know, they've got only pav bhaji and stuff like this.
Yeah.
So we have our version of veg keema pav, which is made of soya. Then we've got this typical berry pulao.
Oh, yes.
Everybody wants it, you know, they tell me that it is, I mean, as good as Britannia or no. But I have my own recipe. Yeah, and I've got an you know, my neighbor, Iranian, I've got the recipe from her. So it's basically flavored rice. So there's butter and there's chicken in the middle, you know, mildly spiced, and there's saffron rice on top with these berries. Here they call it berry pulao, but authentically it's called the zeresh pulao.
Yes.
And then we've got salli margi here. So sallis are these potato chips.
Yes.
You know, and rich tomato onion gravy. We've got pav. We've got this lovely dish here called margina farcha. So now margina farcha basically is like the KFC style chicken, but made the Parsi way. So instead of breadcrumbs, we use, you know, we coat it in egg and deep fry it.
Fantastic.
We've got shoesberry biscuit, naan katais, and patrani machi is also coming. It's on its way.
Oh wow.
So please
Fantastic.
Do the tasting and let me know.
Sure. Thank you so much, Chef.
Pleasure's mine. Good to have you here.
Thank you so much.
Thank you, Neha.
Thank you so much.
Enjoy.
So, Neha, why don't you start with the kebabs and tell us how those
I was about to come to the kebab. I could see many of the dishes out, which is tempting me a lot. Oh, wow. The chutney is made up of coriander, peppermint and salt and chilies. This is very unusual, very nice, very, soft and tender. This is basically a chicken which has minced chicken, which has saffron and onion in it. So what do you think about?
I don't think, like, guys, as Neha said, let me have the kebabs and tell you how they are. As she said, the regular mint coriander chutney.
It's nice. It's very, I mean, this is not too spicy, not too salty. So next dish I'm trying, which is chicken.
Mariana Pacha. So, dosto, as she said, or jaisa hai ki they brought a Parsi and Iranian twist to this KFC style chicken that they have made. And let us have this. So, if you see, very tender chicken, succulent, everything. And it smells good. Plus,
it smells nice.
So, this actually, the coating is not a bland coating that you normally find in a Kentucky fried chicken. It is spicy and has that kind of a twist to it. And this is that Iranian or the Iranian, the Parsi twist where these spices go in and give a very different flavor. But absolutely low spices, very, very low spices.
So this is our Sali Murgi, which has a good quantity of potato crisp on top of it.
Well, the Sali Murgi is actually a preparation which is a mild spicy preparation of tomato, onion, spices and garnished with a lot of these crispies, which actually bring in the real Parsi touch to this dish.
And you can eat this with the pav which they have given to us, which is normal pav.
So this is how this dish is. I'll have it with the lachcha paratha.
Very nice, very unusual taste which I've experienced. Chicken is very tender, it's very smooth. So guys, the next dish I'm going to taste is very famous. We've been knowing that Parsi love dhansak. This is mutton dhansak, which is, let me taste.
So actually a dhansak is a very, very specialized Parsi preparation and it is normally cooked in all celebrations, birth, unfortunately, death of people, but any kind of celebration or any festivity, a dhansak is a very, very key ingredient of that. And normally it's served with brown rice. So I asked Neha to maybe take the brown rice and taste.
So let me taste this rice first, because this is very different rice which I'm seeing in my plate. What I can feel is the onion is caramelized onion which is deep fried. This is normal basmati rice which has been made in those fried onions. And let me taste with this dhansak.
So guys, it's actually the brown rice cooked in caramelized onion, but she just said. And that's the unique dish. We have the unique preparation. And once you have it with the dhansak, you tell them how it is. So let me quickly tell you about dhansak. It's actually prepared in lentils. I just tried having this. So if you have it, just try that.
I feel this is made up of pumpkin.
Yeah, so actually it's slow cooked. The mutton is slow cooked in lentils and pumpkin. And that's why you get this texture. And you get the flavor of the lentils going in with mild spices. And the last and the most favorite, which we had kept it for the last actually, is the very, very, very popular berries pulao. This is one preparation that's only made in Iranian restaurants, friends, let me tell you. The original, I think, was started by the Iranians or the Persians or the Parsis, white rice. Then there's a layer of mutton, and then there is there are saffron flavored rice at the top, which is yellow, served with these amazing berries. So let's taste this. Yeah.
The berry are the bomb. This is ghee.
Guys, the statement of the day: the berries are the bomb from Miss Neha. The berries are the bomb.
and we have cashews in it. We have lots of dry fruits actually. If you see, we have this anardana, we have raisins, we have this fried onion, deep fried onion, cashews, and the mutton has masala in it.
They have something called citra, they have something called gold spot. They have different types of mocktails which are available. And the detailed menu and the description of all the dishes is there in the description box below as well. So in terms of, if you just need to give a rating, so the taste of food, I would rate it a 4 on 5 definitely. How would you rate the taste of food?
I would go for 4.
The ambience of this place being a small, cute little outlet, the ambience I would also rate a 4 on 5.
I would give a 5 out of 5 because the board I see here
gives a 5 on 5 on ambience and an overall rating. So how would you rate an overall rating, Neha?
Overall, I would go for 4.5.
So friends, mere hisab se, I would definitely rate this restaurant overall with definite 4 on 5. If not a 3.5, but definitely a 4 on 5 for sure. So friends, as I said, we are still not finished and we are on to the dessert and the two standout desserts that they have. The Laganu custard, which is a very, very standard Parsi dish that's normally served in most of the festivals and weddings, etc. And the Gulab Jamun, which can never go wrong. And everybody loves the Gulab Jamun. So, Neha, let's start with the Laganu pudding.
I'm very much excited to taste this Laganu pudding. So this Laganu pudding has shredded almonds, very smooth, cheesy.
And I am just enjoying my gulab jamun, which you can try out. Oh, that's so soft. And so bad in terms of calorie content, but it is amazing. So guys, this was the amazing Indo-Pindo Parsi Iranian all-day diner cuisine from the Rustom Battliwala from the Balewadi street in Pune. Our first Indian Parsi all-diner that we have covered, and we will be covering more of those. But I have had a lovely treat, and Neha as well. We've had some amazing different cuisine today, and I'm sure you would have loved having it. So if you really liked the video today, please give us a big thumbs up. Please like this video, please give us a big like, share it with your friends and family, and don't forget to subscribe to our channel. If you've already subscribed, please share it with your friends and family. If you have not subscribed, please do it right now, and also press the bell icon to get regular notifications. Till the time I see you again, or some of our Chow Foodie associates such as Neha and Sarthar, signing off today. Have some amazing food. Respect women, respect children, respect elders. Have a lovely time. Till we see you again. So, ciao.